Dustin Skinner loops it back towards him. Tagoona will try to shake off Dustin Henning. He gets the puck, Henning does, and the Demons look to keep it away. It's Henning, near side, trying to clear it away, picked up by Brandon Blair. His shot ricochets off a dasher high off the glass, and it's kept in play by Casey Mignon to Wehebe Darge, and Roger Tagoona lights the lamp for the first time tonight. It's now a 1-0 Dayton lead with 15:29 left to go in the first period.
It's all about going to the net. Good read by Roger Tagoona, going right to the crease. Plenty of room. No one right around him. That was a bit of fault of Dustin Henning. He kind of lost his focus for a moment, and he got it back, but it was just a little bit too late as Tagoona was all alone.
Roger Tagoona on the season picks up his 14th goal as a Demon in his 34th game. That's his 25th point on the season. Mignon will pick up an assist. That's his 6th in a Demon sweater. 1-0 Dayton, 15:25 left to go, first period. Marks past the red line. We'll send it back. There's Marc Thompson. Pass knocked away by Dustin Skinner. Finding Jesse Felten. Far side, Felten lights the lamp. He puts the biscuit in the basket. Jesse Felten does, for his 17th goal on the season. And the Demons have reclaimed the lead at 2-1 with 3:57 left to go in the first.
Plenty of vision on that shot. He went right to the hash marks, got the puck, and just wired it to the back of the net. No chance for Nick Nieder.
Jesse Felten with his 17th goal in his 35th game with the Demons this season. He gives Dayton a one-goal lead once more, as we'll have a face-off center ice as the minutes of the second period. Shot by the Dashers. That was Jonathan Giuliano. He picks it up right behind Jeff Rose. And sipping around past Brumfield, the linesman, and there's Dustin Skinner. Joe Pace will be up front, shot, and score! Dustin Skinner with his first Demons home goal on the season. He's got 2 assists, now making 1 goal on the night, and it's now 3-1 Dayton, 16:45 left to go in the second.
An absolute laser beam by Dustin Skinner. I believe he shot it right from the hash marks, right between the legs of Nieder. And now it's a 3-1 game. Now, this is where it was at last night as well. It was a 3-1 Dayton lead, and the Dashers would come storming back to tie things up before Lee McClure would score the game winner in the third period. But nonetheless, the Demons up 3-1. No reason to stop here. If you want to try to get the win securely, keep going, keep going. Don't stop here.
16th total goal for... It's a 3-on-2 with Zaleski approaching, making it a 3-on-3. Vanwynsberghe chips it around against Liam Tolley. Felten back to Skinner. Skinner to Vanwynsberghe! Open net for Vanwynsberghe! He just scored his 10th goal in a Demons jersey, his 19th on the season, and gives Dayton a 4-1 lead with 13:54 left to go in the second.
They couldn't do it earlier, but they're certainly doing it now. The goals are starting to pile up. They're starting to run away with the score. No missing for Vanwynsberghe, going right to the net. You'll never miss on an empty net if you go right to the net to catch a pass and put a shot in the net.
Vanwynsberghe with his 10th goal for Dayton. And with his previous 2 stops in Danbury and Danville, he's got 8 more. And it's Henning with that poke away. Kicks it over towards his right. There's Thompson. He'll pull it in. He's faced with his other number 16. That's Alex Norman. We got a tumble there. Mignon flat on his butt, taking that big bump.
And now Mignon and Thompson are exchanging a couple shots.
And Wehebe Darge scores from the Dayton slot all alone. Bam! Goes the puck. Wehebe Darge with his 13th. And Dayton now leads 5-1. 9 minutes left in the second.
I was so busy watching Mignon and Thompson, I didn't even see the rush the other way.
I have to admit, I kind of did that too. I was looking more at that tangling up, and when I twisted my head towards the right, I saw Wehebe Darge right near that powder blue crease. He got Nieder committing towards his right, and Wehebe Darge says, there's the puck, it's in the basket. 5-1 Dayton the score, 9 minutes left to go in the second. That's now 5 goals allowed by Nick Niedert. on 26 shots. That's 21 saves for the goalie. McClure far side, past that line, to Darge in the slot. Nice save by Niedert, and there's a dog pile over the goalie, and we have a lost helmet. We got a scrum. McClure lost his helmet. He's swinging a dasher down.
That's Williams. These two met up just after the last shift, and they wanted each other.
The Stripes break that up very quickly. McClure lost his gloves and his helmet. Still went on against his former teammate, Nick Williams. Two defensemen going out right there as McClure is treated to the Mortal Kombat song as he skates into the penalty box, and Nick Williams, he'll get the same song, just lowered in volume, as he heads towards the box.
Seems like Gary T. but Danville uses the Mortal Kombat theme. It's starting to become a real popular thing in the Federal League nowadays.
It's kind of a cool song. I like the techno remix of it.
I definitely think it's a fitting theme. Yeah, nonetheless, no love lost between two former teams. It's a whole lot of that. You can be friends off ice, but once you hit the ice, it's game on, and you're instant enemies.
So both teams charged with 2 minutes. I believe they're going to call roughing calls upon McClure and Nick Williams. Pick back up. It's Olsland sending around. It's touched up by Marks. Marks kicks it out to Tagoona with one dasher towards the right. And Tagoona tangled up with Williams, stopping that shorthander goal. There's a shot by Sean Fisher. Kicks back out, and a shorthander for Roger Tagoona. Niedert could not control that rebound. It comes all the way back, and Tagoona swipes it on the right-hand side of Niedert. Right now, the red light is on behind the net of Niedert, and the referee talking it over. Williams
and
shaking his
head. And now Kellemeyer all at the bench. He's furious at the referee.
He's fuming right now.
And Joe Pace is now giving it to the ref as well. They are just livid on the bench.
So right now, if that does stand, Roger Tagoona with his second on the night and his 15th on the season, that will give him a shorthander goal.
They are going to converge. They're going to look at it. The goal's on the board. Now it is.
Roger Tagoona with his second. It's a shorthander for Tagoona. And it's now a four-goal lead again for Dayton at 6-2.
Federal Hockey League teams have been really lacking is some organ music. It's something that they've been missing. We'll have to see if they start to pick it up with the organ music as the season goes on.
Wehebe Darge with a breakaway. Pace behind him. Wehebe Darge scores! It's now 7-2 Dayton with 15:10 left to go in the third. Beautiful pass to Darge all alone. One defender behind him, and Darge puts the biscuit in the basket.
Well, usual Demon Stashers hockey. It's a five-goal game.
For Wehebe Darge, that would be his 14th goal on the season, his second on the night, and that's two Demons now with two goals apiece.
And now it's 7-2 here. A little updated, 7-2 is the final in Danbury. The Whalers have defeated the Privateers 7-2.
Puck comes free. Tagoona will be the first one touching it. He'll swipe it around. Niedert comes in, interrupts that pass to Skinner. Nice job by Niedert poking that pass away. That could have been a goal for Skinner. Meanwhile, Skinner's got the loose puck, tries to dump it in, and he does! Two dashers right to his left and right. That doesn't stop Skinner. He pulls it through, and Dayton now leads 8-2 with 8:39 left to go in the third.
My goodness, forget the highlight reel. That goal was the highlight reel. Ducked away from two dashers, got the puck back after it went off a dasher stick. Right by the leg of Niedert into the back of the net. It's 8-2.
Skinner with that goal for Dayton, and that would be his second on the contest. So you have Darge, you have Tagoona, and now you have Skinner with two goals each. We have the Looney Tunes theme. This has been a weird night.
Yeah,
this really hasn't been.
Music to the on ice. Could be an episode of Looney Tunes on ice.
Make note, I gotta say that's all, folks, to end this broadcast. Norman slips behind the Zamboni doors, and that is all she wrote for tonight's game.
Maybe they're just playing around. I apologize.
Final score, the Dayton Demonz 8 and the Danville Dashers 3. Jeff Rose picks up the win. That's his 9th on the season. Niedert takes the loss. That's his 11th on the season. A great effort by the Dayton Demonz tonight. They take down Danville 8-3. Dayton improves to 24-8-3. Danville falls to 10-27-2. Still don't understand that 2 minutes on the board against Dayton, then they erase it. Not 100% sure, but.
Yeah, maybe they just figured because there's only 7 seconds left, the 5 lead wasn't really worth it.
So that being said, we'll have the 3 stars of the game, and we'll recap the game for you here on the Gem City Sports Network and the FHL Sports Network. Keep it with us as the Demonz skate around the circle, high-fiving the fans that made it out to Hera tonight. Stay with us. We'll be back after a quick breather. Final score, Dayton Demonz 8, Danville Dashers 3. Stars of the game look like this. It's Wehebe Darge, the number 3 star for Dayton. 2 goals, 4 shots, a +1 ranking on the night for Darge. Roger Tagoona on the night, 2 goals, 1 assist, a +5 ranking, and 4 shots for him. And your number one star tonight is Dustin Skinner. 2 goals, 3 assists, a plus 4 ranking, and 11, count them, 11 shots for the Demons. We'll be right back.